Hi guys, let's assume we are developing a simple app. The app firstly allows us to record our voice. Goodbye, Mr. Bond. And it then plays back the voice in different avatars.
Goodbye, Mr. Bond.
Goodbye, Mr. Bond.
While simple in functionality, there are quite a few things going on under the hood. Our app firstly needs buttons, images, and perhaps titles. It also needs to store audio files. Finally, it needs to play the correct audio file when buttons are clicked. I am now going to categorize these three points into three buckets. The labels, buttons, and text are all a very visible part of the application. So let's put them under the view heading. Then we have the audio files or the data. I will put these under the data or model heading. And finally, we have the interactions between the view and model when buttons are clicked. I will put these under the controller heading. Another good analogy of this pattern can be taken from the world of cinema. You can think of the view as the actors in a film. Actors are the most visible part of the film. A controller is like a director who manages activities on a set, including the actors. And finally, you can think of the model as the backstage area where the sets and other items used in the film are stored. So what you're seeing here is a high-level overview of a design pattern called the Model View Controller, or MVC for short, which is used to create apps, among other things. By spreading functionality across these three objects, developers achieve cleaner and more reusable solutions. So guys, this brings us to the end of the session. I have put up additional reading material in the video description, so do check it out. And as always, send us your comments and help us make smarter videos. Take it easy and bye for now.